take some bacon and position it on each side. Perfect. This is going to be a breakfast that will knock your socks off. And our last piece of bacon goes right down the middle, and you just want to poke it down in there so it really fits into all the grooves, just like that. This is perfect. Now I'm going to take some pancake batter that we've prepared, and you just pour that over right on top of our bacon. Now you actually want to cover each of that section because we're gonna be forming cups, essentially. There's something I need from the fridge. Would you grab it for me? It's on the top shelf.
Okay.
You'll see it.
Ah, cheddar.
We're just gonna sprinkle some cheese on top. Now, it's optional. I like the mix of sweet and savory with this kind of breakfast, but if you don't wanna add cheese, you don't have to. But y'all let me know in the comments, yes or no to cheese with pancakes. That should be good. All right, now we've got our oven preheated to 400 degrees. We're gonna bake this. Honestly, we're gonna keep an eye on it. You're gonna know when it's done, when you can use a toothpick, just like you would with a cake. And when the toothpick comes out clean, that's when you know it's ready. Kyle's laughing at me because he saw me stutter. So our breakfast bake is in the oven. It's almost done, but I've got a little bit of extra bacon, and I'm gonna show you a really cool hack that you can use your waffle iron with. First, we're gonna spray it, then we're gonna take some brown sugar.
Light brown sugar.
Light brown sugar, sprinkle some of that right on top. Trust me on this. Now we're gonna take our bacon and just lay those pieces out. Now it's okay if it gets a little bit overlapped, it's still gonna cook all the way. Scoop this one around down here. Perfect. Top that with a little bit more of the brown sugar. What's the best secret that y'all have, by the way, for keeping the brown sugar from getting hard? Or what do you do once it's already gotten hard? How do you fix that problem? All right, so we're gonna cook that. We got our bacon and our brown sugar. This is essentially a candied bacon recipe that you can make in a waffle iron.
Do you know what Bacon's favorite musical is?
Bacon's favorite musical?
Uh-huh.
No.
Grease. Don't go baking my heart.
I couldn't if I fried. This looks like it's gonna be good.
Smells so good.
I'm washing hands.
Stand by, rolling on top here in a minute. 5, 4, 3, 2.
Doesn't that smell good?
It's so good.
You're not gonna believe this. Candy bacon in minutes. Check this out. Doesn't that look good?
Look at that.
Look at that. Now, do you like your bacon crispy or do you like it floppy? That is the question. I like mine crispy. Kyle, you like yours floppy.
I'm gonna try and
floppy.
Okay, let's try this.
Okay. Cut, take two.
Okay, there you go. Okay, ready?
Yep.
Now that looks so good. I like my bacon crispy, but what's great about this method for cooking is that you have a little bit of both. You've got a little bit of the softer bacon and also the crispy bacon because it cooks it from both sides. Kyle, you're gonna try this, right?
Absolutely, like, give me a little piece of
this. I want this crispy piece. I'll give you the, well, you like your sloppy, so there you go.
All right, here we go.
All right,
mm-hmm.
Check this out. Oh my gosh, this is delicious. Y'all, if you have not tried candied bacon, specifically in the waffle iron, you are missing out.
I know. It is so good.
Oh my gosh. This is actually really, really good.
Mm.
Want some more?
Mm-hmm.
This is so good.
Nice.
All right. It's ready to come out of the oven, but I can't stop eating the bacon. I'm gonna go get it. All right, y'all. It's nice and fluffy, just like we wanted. It took about 15 or 20 minutes to bake fully, and I double-checked it using that toothpick. Now I'm going to just use the foil and slide it out. Kyle, will you grab that and scoot it to the side?
All right.
Perfect. We don't need this anymore, so that's going to go away.
Okay.
Now we're gonna get the foil off.
All right.
Now it's coming off pretty easily.
Maybe we should have sprayed
it. But I think it would have been even better if I had sprayed it. But for some reason, I always forget to spray. Now, we're gonna flip this over. And we're gonna see what it looks like on the other side with that woven pattern of the bacon. And it's okay if it's not completely done, because this is gonna go back in the oven.
Because we got one more crazy step.
One more step here.
This is gonna be insane. Okay. All right.
So I'm gonna pick this up and flip it into this pan.
Here, I'll just hold the pan here. You flip it end for end right there.
Ready?
Oh, I got an idea. Why don't we just put the pan over top this way?
Oh, that makes sense.
All right, so go like that.
Okay, beautiful. And now that was so smart. Wait. Now I gotta get underneath.
All right. Whoa.
Okay, that was a close one.
Okay, now
we did it.
Let's see what this looks like.
So underneath this, we should have some perfect little cups. And inside of these cups, we're going to pour 6 eggs. And then we're gonna bake these as well. And then we're gonna add some more seasoning. And then we've got a delicious and fancy breakfast bake. I cannot wait to see how this turned out. I'm gonna peek. Okay, important question. Do we want the bacon to be nice and crispy, or do you want it to be floppy? Y'all tell me in the comments, because that really is going to determine how long I cook this for. We've got 2 pieces of foil here.
Okay, so just peel it off.
Okay, here we go.
Is it coming off nice, or is it?
It's coming. It's coming. This is such a genius idea. I'm so excited to see how this is going to turn out. Wow. Okay. Amazing. And y'all always tell me that I'm too stingy with the cheese, so we're gonna go back in and hit this with just a little bit more cheese in the bottom. But, and one egg goes right in there. And another.
Oh,
we got 2 in that one. Ooh, look at that one.
Look at that.
So these were white eggs, and that was a brown egg. Can you taste the difference between white and brown eggs? We clearly see a difference here, but can you taste the difference? That's the real question. We're gonna add some pepper to each one and a little bit of salt. And that's it. This is ready to go into the oven. We're gonna bake this once more, and that's gonna give us some fully cooked eggs. And we're also gonna have some nice crispy bacon on top, and it looks like our cleanup crew has arrived. 400 degrees, once more. What are you doing?
Are you supposed to be eating that egg? Is that for puppies?
Now, I wasn't sure if this idea was gonna work, but it did, y'all. You just wait, and it's gonna taste good.
Exciting.
All right, so look at this. We've got some nice crispy bacon. We've got our egg, and yes, they are fully cooked. Look at that. I think I'm gonna go for that one. I think that was the brown egg that looks like it's nice, and that one looks like it's nice and well done. I don't like runny eggs. What do y'all think? Do you like them when they're runny or dippy? Let me know in the comments whether you want yours well done or runny. I'm gonna go with the well done egg. Now I'm gonna see if I can just cut this using my knife. Oh yeah, this is gonna work just fine.
All right.
Now you could even have more bacon if you want. I ended up using just enough, but I think we could have a little bit more too. So this was definitely a new recipe. People often ask, you know, where do you get these recipes? Well, sometimes I dream them up, and this is one of those, and I think it's gonna be delicious. This is basically just like a Bisquick mix. It's pancake and waffle biscuit batter. All right, I think I need a spatula to get this out, or is it gonna come out? Oh no, it's coming right out. Now remember, we got cheese on the bottom too. You doubted me, but it's coming out. Look, y'all. I'm gonna get that bacon that ran away. Don't wanna lose that bacon. Look, this looks delicious. I cannot wait to try this. It's, what do you think I should describe this as? It's kind of like a casserole, but It's just more of an artistic display of breakfast. Okay. I think that is a good way to describe it.
All right, here we go.
Now, we're gonna cut into that egg now. I'm sure y'all are wondering what that egg looks like. So we're gonna go ahead and slice it just this way so you can see if our egg is totally done. And guess what?
Look at that, it's done all the way through.
Doesn't that look good? That is perfect. This is exactly what I wanted with my egg. Okay, I'm just gonna go in and take a big bite.
Good news, the bacon is good.
The bacon is nice and crispy. You were skeptical about this, weren't you?
I was. I did not think this was gonna turn out.
Okay, that's good.
I'm just gonna break pieces off.
Have some egg.
Mm-hmm.
Mmm! I know what this is missing. Don't go anywhere.
I'm never left on camera alone by myself. Hope things go well.
Syrup.
All right.
Okay, ready?
Mm-hmm.
Right on top. So this is almost like a McGriddle.
And I think it's healthy too, right?
No, I didn't say that. That was all you. So we've got a little bit of syrup on there with our bacon.
It's good.
Oh my gosh.
It's interesting. It's
actually really good. Mmm. It's good with that bacon.
Mm-hmm.
What do you rate it? I'm giving it an 8.
I was going to give it a 100.
I thought you said a 1. No, it's actually really good, y'all. No, it's quite inventive. We have fun making new recipes for you. But this is one that surprised us. You are going to enjoy this one for sure. It's really good.
It is good. Mm-hmm. Congratulations.
You didn't eat the egg.
It's gross.